dish for the gravy, for the yakni which you are making up for the biryani. Which you want to give the thin then we add a little saffron water along with the top to the yummy over there. You can add a little butter, a cream as we have done. You can add a little cream over there. Mix all the ingredients together, and this will give you a very a thick and a normal like runny like so gravy along with the chicken. So now layering can be done. So if you take a pan, maybe a simple glass of salt. You add a salt along with according to your taste. This can be done. The biryani can be made in your microwave. You can use a bowl. In that bowl, you can on the base you can spread some rice which has been pre-cooked. Maximum to the extent of like you are doing it in a microwave, so you have to cook it to 90 to 95%. So this can be done in there, and you get a nicer taste. Okay, put some rice on the base. You can add that the yakni which you have made up over there on the top of that, and then what we do is we put up a second layer of rice. You put up a second layer of rice on top of the yakni. Over there you can put up chicken and the rest, everything which has been left along with you. You can save a little, I think two or three tablespoons of yakni gravy along with that, so that you can put it on top and you can garnish it. Then the third layer of rice comes on top. You can garnish it with ground onions on top, ginger onions, green chili onions, mint. And add a little cardamom and mace powder on top of it. You can put a cream, add a little butter, a recipe which is with the chicken bread around, and you can put it on top of that. After that, you can add a little ginger onions on top. The saffron water can be sprinkled on top. You don't have anything left. If you have a lid, the boxer bomb. It's fine. Otherwise, you can cover it with anything, any plate which is basically, the microwave shape. You can cover it out, and you can put it into the microwave for if it's a big portion bowl, hardly 7 to 8 minutes is maximum of time. Or if it's a small portion of four to five minutes would be more than enough. You can put it over there and you can make your own biryani at your home. You can enjoy the same taste and textures as you can enjoy the way we do it over there at Tuaravala. Anything else you would like to ask or something, I would be much more like to have
hello.
Any questions, anyone?
Any queries, any questions, something someone would like to ask? That would give you a very nice brownian color. So wash it nicely 4 or 5 times till the time you get in, water gets clear. Soak it for overnight. And I basically do over there in Florida, and even we at our homes, before putting it to a boil, you can add on little red chilies. Red chili powder or dehi mirch powder, which is available on the market. If you got a ginger garlic paste along with you, so you can add on to that little salt. Adding this will basically give you a very beautiful, colorful, beautiful red color at that end when your dal has been boiled. and while boiling, you can add on 2 tablespoons or 2 teaspoons of desi ghee or maybe a quarter of a butter over there. So the dal will get the flavor of butter and even the texture will come out nice. The moment after the time is cooked on a slow fire, I think it takes hardly 45 minutes to cook overnight soaked dal. After that, you can temper it with in desi ghee. You can add on red chili powder, salt, add on tomato puree. A fresh tomato puree would be beautiful to do so. If you're not having that, express ways, you add on a little tin which is available, but tetra packs are available for homemade or not. You can add on that. You can add on ginger garlic paste over there. Add, mix it well. Mix the cooked overnight dal into that paratha. And cook it, stir it nicely. While stirring it, add 100 grams of your Amul butter into that. Stir it nice and that's ready for you.
All right, thank you so much. That was great. I think everybody wants to have some biryani now.
Okay, now, while I was with the guests, there was one question which came up. Somebody among the guests wanted to know what's the difference between Shahi Paneer and Kadhai Paneer. Could you please answer that?
Shahi Paneer is basically is being served outside in Delhi and even across the states. Is basically what we call it in our languages, the professional language, that is a paneer makhni. It's basically the tomato gravy and cottage cheese cooked together. So that comes out to be a shahi paneer. Along with the, we add on a little cream and butter to that. The difference between the shahi paneer and the kadhai paneer is, in kadhai paneer we also add on tomato, onions and bell peppers cubes. Bell peppers like green, yellow and red capsicums cut into cubes and even onions diced and tomatoes. You can saute them along with the butter first and then you can add on to the gravy. Shahi paneer is much, the gravy is much more smoother. The shahi paneer, the gravy is much more smoother, and in kadhai paneer we have got a kadhai masala which has been made up by pounded coriander seeds, red chili and little cumin and fennel. These four things have been broiled together. You can pound them and pounded masala can be added onto the gravy. So this comes out to be a nice
curry. Thank you so much, chef. And now, one more question which came up from the audience was, now that you've made chicken biryani for us, the audience wanted to know what would be the recipe for it. Where can they find the recipe for it?
The recipe
for chicken biryani.
The ingredients or the recipe?
The recipe.
What we can do is, we'll be updating it on the Kuala Lumpur website. So you can come up and visit over there and you can check it out.
Alright, so members of the audience, you got your answer. The recipe for chicken biryani would be uploaded on the website of Rana Villa. So everybody in here, I would request them, if they would like to know what a cooked chicken biryani is, they can always visit www.ranavilla.com to check out new recipes and the exclusive chicken biryani recipe by Chef Siddharth Sharma. Alright, so can I have any more questions or shall we? Audience?
I cannot hear you.
Start serving.
Alright, so now, start serving. So, Chef, thank you so much for telling us what chicken biryani is all about. And now, I would request the audience to please come up and have a bite of what Chef has made for us. So, can we please have somebody to come up and serve it?